that same day, two of them were on their way to a village called Emmaus, which was about 7 miles from Jerusalem. Together, they were discussing everything that had taken place. And while they were discussing and arguing, Jesus himself came near and began to walk along with them. But they were prevented from recognizing him. Then he asked them, "What is this dispute that you're having with each other as you are walking?" And they stopped walking and looked discouraged. The one named Cephas answered him, "Are you the only visitor in Jerusalem who doesn't know the things that happened there in these days?" "What things?" he asked them. So they said to him, "The things concerning Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet powerful in action and speech before God and all the people, and how our chief priests and leaders handed him over to be sentenced to death, and they crucified him. But we were hoping that he was the one who was about to redeem Israel." Besides all this, it's the third day since these things happened. Moreover, some women from our group astounded us. They arrived early at the tomb, and when they didn't find his body, they came and reported that they had seen a vision of angels who said he was alive. And some of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they didn't see him. He said to them, "How foolish you are, and how slow to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Wasn't it necessary for the Messiah to suffer these things and enter into his glory? Then, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted for them the things concerning himself in all the scriptures." And they came near the village where they were going, and he gave the impression that he was going further. But they argued, urged him, "Stay with us, because it's almost evening and now the day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. And it was as he reclined at the table with them that he took the bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he disappeared from their sight. They said to each other, "Weren't our hearts burning within us while he was talking with us on the road and explaining the scriptures to us?"
Thank you.
it's all for your glory. It is all for your glory, Lord. Yes, Lord Jesus. In this season of waiting to see your face, ourselves like the disciples on the road to Emmaus, when all that we had hoped for, all that we had believed in, seems far off and lost. Would you help us to see you rightly in this season of waiting and longing? Would we trust in the name of the Lord and know that you keep your word, you keep your promise, and you never fail us? Would we be able to see how you are being glorified even in this seemingly dark and heavy and disappointing season, Lord? Questions aloud, Lord. Would you meet us and make our hearts burn within us with fresh love?